This is an oral present or oral history interview conducted for the Witness to War Serving a Nation project at Nauset Regional High School on Cape Cod, Massachusetts. For the sake of this interview, please state your full name and community which you now reside.
John Robert Healy, live in East Harwich, Massachusetts. I'm part of the 102nd Security Forces Squadron out of Otis State National Guard Base here on Cape Cod.
Right, and the first question is, why did you choose the Air Force?
I chose the Air Force. Been a career field. It's where my family grew up. My father was Air Force, my grandfather was Air Force, so.
Was there a specific reason to join?
Want to be a cop.
Okay.
And serve a community.
Right. How long did you serve?
How long served? Currently, it's going to be 11 years.
Okay. What was your job title?
My job title is assistant flight chief. I'm in charge of about 8 to 10 personnel on my flight. With that regards to its law enforcement, custodials would be our buildings, making sure all the buildings are secure, all our assets are secure, and nothing's penetration into our fence line.
Okay. Why did you stay for a long time?
It's a good job, good career field. That's just a good career field.
Okay. What was your biggest takeaway from everything you did?
Biggest takeaway is meeting different personnel and individuals when I'm deployed and working with doing special events like the Boston Marathon. I was there at the Boston Marathon the year afterwards from the bombings, and that was the biggest highlight of my life.
What countries did you go to?
I've been to Iraq for 7 months, visited Qatar, which is IED, been to Ireland, Romania. That's it.
Okay.
How were they like? Like, how were the countries like? Like, the, how were the people and the community?
The community? People? It was different verse of people. Ireland, which I was over there for a few hours. The culture's different. Flying into the place is beautiful. When I flew into Kuwait, that's another place I visited. Different, especially when going from 80-degree weather to 120-degree weather was quite the shock. Qatar, a beautiful place. You can actually see United Emirates from our place. When we flew into Iraq, it was very different. Different smell. People, they very friendly. They wanted us there, and you could tell people were kind of hesitant around us.
Mm-hmm.
But it was a very good experience.
All right. What was your most terrifying thing you saw during your time serving?
Most terrifying thing I saw when. The one night we were on a patrol, and we got what is called a pitch out, and which means an army unit was attacked, and with civilians. When they came through, there was an ambulance, or a car. They were going to a search pit, but they were pulled over to the side if it was civilian, which was a father and his son, were blown up, and in order to go to the hospital, they had to be searched. Which meant a full body search. It was very terrifying. I still picture it right now, what I had to do. I don't want to get into it really too gruesomely, but I wouldn't want to say you kids see what I see.
Okay. What was it like coming home after your service?
Colors.
Okay.
Going from a desert and all it was tan everywhere and white vehicles. And everybody in uniform. Getting back to the States, seeing green trees. I get back in the middle of winter, and it was snow on the ground. That was amazing. People driving, going from driving overseas, the faster you can go on our base was 35 miles an hour. Doing the speed limit was weird. People in a rush to go everywhere. That was the biggest thing I got from being over there. Don't be in a rush. You're there for purpose, and you get back, you're like, they're in a rush to go anywhere, to go stop and shop. That was the biggest thing I when I got back. It was weird.
What was your experience like in boot camp?
Great. I would love to become a drill instructor. It was one of the best things physically and mentally I'd ever got out of it. I loved it.
Was it very challenging?
It was for my age. When I first got there, the first week, 2 weeks when I was there, it was very physical. They lit up a little bit, but you're constantly going.
Did you have to like prepare for like mentally for anything like that?
You're never prepared.
Okay.
They're always gonna yell at you. Okay. No matter what, you sit down the wrong way and you don't put your canteen under your seat a certain distance. You have to be like right in the middle of your chair. And they come over there and there'd be two guys, man or woman, just yelling at you with their, how do you call them, Sheriff Beaver T. Justice hats, you know, poking your head. So.
What was the hardest decision you had to make during your service?
Tell my family I was going overseas. That was the biggest one.
What did your family think about you leaving?
They were scared, nervous. My kids were young. They didn't understand. You probably remember being in the classroom with Nick when I Skyped you guys. That was not being around the kids, not being around the family for the holidays. I missed my anniversary, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's when I was over there.
What was the food like there?
Same as around here. It was all catered. It was actually pretty good. We ate like kings. Lobsters, crab legs, Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving was just like home. Christmas just like home. Turkey, stuffing, ham, you name it, they had it.
What was the best part of serving?
Seeing different cultures and seeing different personnel that I deploy with from different all around the United States and overseas. It was quite the experience, and I'm still to this day, I talk to them all the time.
Describe how you prepared for a mission.
Prepared? Just making sure you had all the equipment. You knew the guys you were working with. We all became very close, so we knew each other, we got each other's back if anything happened. Sometimes we're split up. I was by myself once, a couple times over there. And just to prepare, just this is what I can do for the night. I'm a 12 hours of shift. And go on.
Do you stay in contact with the people who you served with?
Oh yes. Okay. Pretty much every week I'll call them. Or we'll talk. It's a monthly thing, but every week, every 2 weeks, we'll be in touch.
Are they mostly like your best friends, like closest people?
Oh yeah.
Do they live around here, or just all over the place?
All over the place.
Okay. If you could go back and change something in the war, what would it be?
The war had already started by the time I got there. Good question. I really wouldn't have an answer to that, but to change something, I wish it got over sooner.
Okay.
Went over there so longer.
Makes sense. What was the foreign lifestyle like in the local community?
Different. The one thing we had to get used to is not showing our, like, if we were sitting down, showing the bottom of our feet, our hands. If you shake your arm right hand, that's a good thing. If you put your, don't go touch with your left hand, that's a very offensive. Especially if they saw the bottom of your feet. It's very, very offensive. Most of the men over there with the left hands and women, they don't have toilet paper.
Okay.
So, their culture, they're very hands-on. They want to come up and hug you. They embrace you. It's, they're nice, to some degree. I met a couple bad ones, but they were pretty much taken care of. They weren't on a base.
If you knew what you knew now, would you still have joined?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. In a heartbeat. I'd do it all over again in a heartbeat.
Last question. What did you do for work before serving?
I was actually a plumber. I worked for EF Winslow, Whiteley's Plumbing Heating. And during the bad times, I always thought I would join the Air Force. I wish I did when I was 18, but I joined when I was 30. And it's been the best job I've ever had.
Would you like to go back?
Overseas?
Yes.
Most definitely. Yeah. I'd love to go to Afghanistan. I'd love to go back to Qatar, where we went to Qatar before we went to Iraq. We were over there for one night. When we left, we got stuck there for a week and a half. So all the only thing we did was sit by the pool and eat a Dairy Queen and Burger King.
Did you know how to use a weapon before you went to boot camp?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What type of weapons did you use?
Basically handguns. But yeah, when I was in boot camp, even here now, I shoot the M240 Bravo, the M249. I carry around the M4 carbine. 9mm is my siren arm, day in, day out. Two or three grenade launcher. I've shot in the 50 cal. What else? The minigun. It's very fun. You actually got to shoot that when I was over in Iraq with the Navy SEALs. They brought us out. We went to the range, and you guys want to use the minigun? Yeah.
Did you have, flashes? Did you ever use any of those? Or?
We had them. Yep. Actually, when I was overseas, I was actually a 203 gunner, and I had my 203 grenades on my vest, and I had a can next to me if I needed them.
How was where you lived, where you were staying?
I stayed in Iraq, we actually stayed in trailers. It was a trailer with three rooms, four guys to a room. When I left, it was four guys to a room because we split up. The new crew came in our room, so we had four of us. It was just me and my best friend, who I went to basic with, was in the room. And bed, we had a TV, we had our computers, bathrooms, we had to go out of our room and walk over to a different area. But it was decent, air conditioned, heat. So.
Have you lived on Cape Cod your whole life?
Yeah.
How did your father, did you say your father was in the Air Force? How did he take it when you decided to go?
He was hesitant, but he knew I always wanted to go. Actually, firefighting was my first choice. But when they took the jets out of, they're talking about taking the jets off the base, they're closing down the fire department and making all civilians. That was actually my first choice. I already enlisted as a firefighter. And then I had to change career fields, so I became a cop.
What's it like currently working in the Air Force?
Being as an NCO, being a staff sergeant, you're constantly trying to mentor the new kids coming in and trying to keep the same old structure as was instilled in the Air Force. A lot of the kids coming out nowadays don't have that structure and they're very entitled of what they need and what they want. And you're going to still, hey, you are in the military. This is the way it is. You chose this life. And you try to instill that. A lot of little kids grasping it. A few don't. And a few won't make it. For they'll probably do their 6 years and get out.
So. Do you get to choose the amount of years you stay in the Army? Or?
And with the Air Force, I signed up for 6. And my reenlistment is always 6 years. Now that I'm getting older, it goes to 4. And actually, my enlistment ends in 2 years. And I'll do another 6 and then do whatever, how many years I have left for my 20. And if I can stay in past 20, I'll stay in past 20.
Mm-hmm. Are there any more goals you want to work up to in the Air Force or anything?
Ranking-wise?
Mm-hmm.
Just making sure all my troops are taken care of and their progression to become NCOs and senior NCOs is the way I want to even go officer.
Was there anybody you looked up to when you were serving?
Yeah. He actually lives right down the street in Harwich. He actually just retired last year, and he was my mentor going through it.
Yeah, all right, thank you.
Thank you so much.